Welcome to this video. Today, you're going to learn the difference between sell and sale. This is a question that a student had, and it's a great question because I think that both of these are going to be a part of your regular vocabulary. Of course, I'm Jennifer from jforestenglish.com, and this channel is dedicated to helping you sound like a fluent, confident, natural English speaker. Now, before we go any further, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon so you're notified every time I post a new lesson. Now, let's dive in with this video. Let's talk about the difference between sell and sale. Now, the main difference is that sell is a verb to sell. And sale is a noun, which means it's a thing. We can use it with a sale, the sale, or even for sale. So let's talk about the verb to sell. Now, to sell, this simply means to make something available for purchase. But because it's a verb, we're talking about it as an action, okay? So keep that in mind. For example, the store sells athletic goods. Now, of course, because it's a verb, we have to conjugate our verb with the subject. Here, the store, it, so we need to add an S onto the verb. And we also would need to put it in the correct verb tense as well. So I could say, in the past, I sold. Sold is the past simple of the verb to sell. I sold my bike. I sold my bike. Now, sale as a noun. There are different structures. I'll talk about the two most common. And the first structure is something to be for sale. For sale. But remember, sale is a noun, so we still need a verb in the sentence. So in this sentence structure, it's something and then the verb to be for sale. For example, this house is for sale. Now, as a noun, for sale just means available for purchase. So it has the same meaning, but we're talking about it as a thing. We're not talking about it as an action. This house is for sale. Now, sale as a noun, we can also say that something and then the verb to be on sale, okay? Let me give you an example. I could say, do you sell bikes? So I'm asking, imagine you're a store, and I'm asking, are bikes available for purchase? Do you sell bikes? Sell as a verb. And then you could reply back and say, yes, and all of our bikes are on sale right now. All of our bikes are, the verb to be, on sale. What does that mean? All of our bikes are on sale. Well, when something is on sale, it means it's being offered at a lower price than normal. So if the bike is regularly $1,000, perhaps the sale price is $800. The bike is on sale. Now, using the article a sale, that would just be talking about the fact that things in the store are available for purchase at a discounted price. So I could say, this store is having a sale this weekend. So I'm not specifying specific items, I'm just saying in general, things at that store are being offered, are being sold at a lower price. The store is having a big sale this weekend. All their bikes are on sale. So we use on sale to be on sale when we're specifying the specific thing. All of our bikes are on sale. So now you know how to use the verb sell in different verb tenses. You know how to use sale as a noun in terms of for sale, on sale, and also a sale. So that's four expressions. Why don't you practice all four in the comments below to get really comfortable with them? If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and of course, subscribe. Now, before you go, make sure you head on over to my website, jforestenglish.com, and download your free speaking guide. In this guide, I share 6 tips on how to speak English fluently and confidently. And until next time, happy studying. Woohoo! Awesome job with this video. I know it can be a little complicated. That's why you need to practice. You need to form your own sentences to get really comfortable using the different meanings. So I want to see 4 sentences in the comments below. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye!